What's happening, my people? It is a Monday that I'm filming this, and I'm coming to y'all with my hot five and odd five of the week. But we've switched it up. I'm not going to go odd five this week. I'm going to give y'all my hot eight. My hot eight this week, because I had some hot fire this week. Does that correlate to having a great sales week?
Nope.
We'll see at the end, because I could have had just a couple of great days and had a few trash days and ended up not making what I wanted to make. Let's go ahead and dive into this. Oh, let me introduce myself. My name is Derek.
My man.
I am the fundamental to side hustle as known on YouTube and Instagram. If you're a subscriber to me already and been with me for a minute and or new, I appreciate y'all. I appreciate y'all so much. Thank you.
To this
if
day.
If you want to become a subscriber, go ahead and hit that subscribe button since you're watching and hit that thumbs up. I'm always going to ask for the thumbs up, even if you think the video is trash. I'm gonna need you to hit that thumbs up and not come back again. How about that? Sounds like a fair deal to me. Anyhow, let's go ahead and jump into this hot eight, because we're not doing odd this week. We're gonna go with the hot eight, starting at number eight, I think. If it ends up being seven, that's okay. Starting at number eight. So sold this pair of Lululemon for $75.61, $81.02 with shipping. I have a homie, he has a connection on Lululemon, so he hooks me up. This stuff sells really fast for me. I get it for a semi-decent price. Look, I pay up for this stuff. Sometimes you gotta pay up for something when you know it's gonna flip fast. We're gonna talk about paying up when we get towards the top. But I have about $42 into each pair of these Lululemon. $81.02 on this pair. The number seven item, another pair of Lululemons. Lululemon mapped out 28-inch camel color. Just sold for $80.01. $83.51 with shipping. My number six item, another pair of Lululemon. Now, everybody, I'm telling y'all, if y'all have this exercise, clothing, equipment, anything like that, post it right now. Everyone coming in hot this year for this, new year, new me type of nonsense that's going to happen on New Year's. Happens every time. They're going to come out here with this enthusiasm. They're going to be feeling some type of way, coming with that energy. Thinking they're about to come out here and get their exercise on. What they realize, what they're going to realize real fast is, not just exercising. You have to change the way you eat. You can't keep eating the same thing and go exercise and expect you to lose weight. No, you're basically exercising to eat at that point. That's where I'm at. I love to eat. So I can cut back on my eating to help me lose weight if I want to lose weight.
What?
But I don't. All right. So I'm all right right now. I'm just telling y'all, anyone who's in the reselling world, post their exercise stuff. I promise you, it's going to sell in December, this month, rolling into January, because everyone is going to be training for the Olympics in January. And then in February, they're going to be laying their lazy butts back down. That's all I'm saying. Anyhow, I think I'm at number six. My number five item. Number five. I don't even know if I went over number six. We're just going to skip right to number five. And number five in my hot eight is this Hot Wheels set. I think I sold one last week. I got this from a online arbitrage. It's a set of nine Hot Wheels, and when you put them all together, it makes this Death Star for Star Wars. I have $45 into this. It sold for $89.01, $105.70 with shipping.
Yes!
I paid up on almost all this stuff, but it flips fast. So you don't have to sit on that. If you're going to pay up, make sure it's something that sells fast by doing your research and get it listed as soon as you get it. So you're not holding on to that money, right? Inventory is essentially money that you've invested in something and it's just sitting there doing nothing if it's not posted. my number four item in my hot eight is, this is a Geo Safari laptop. This is a vintage laptop. It's from the early 90s. Brand new in the package. I found this at an estate sale. I have $2 into this. Y'all know that's my number, and I'm keeping it real. $2 into this thing, because I bought tons of stuff and it broke down to $2 each. This sold for $92.01, $118.76 with shipping. Huh. My number two item, my number two item in my hot eight is, it's a combination. A guy had ordered two things all together. And the crazy thing about this, I was about to cancel this dude because there was an order opened up for him for no pay. The guy took forever to pay. I have it set up to where it automatically opens the case. It was almost at that point to where I was going to close it, and he came through and paid. And the crazy thing about this, this was a model bike, like a 10-speed. One of them, I got $5 into this 10-speed, and the other thing I have $5 into, so $10 total into this bundle. He paid $150 plus shipping.
Excellent.
Yo, this little, when I tell you this little bike model, this model bike was literally like this big. It was tiny. Dropping money. And my number one item, and I put it together because it's two of them at the top, it's two laptops. I have $200 into each one of these laptops. Once again, I paid up. I knew they were going to flip really fast because there was only six listed and about 40 sold. So I knew they were going to sell fast, so I had no problem paying up. Got them for $200, sold them for $325.01 each. One paid, one was free shipping, and the other, there was $25 shipping and handling on it. Quick $120, $130. Dude, I'll take that all day. I literally had these laptops for 3 days. And we auctioned off one of those laptops for my girl, Jennifer. Appreciate you popping in and out of each people's channels, helping them out. You always dropping links. You deserve everything you get. Auctioned that off. She got all the money. Win-win situation for me. I still made all my money back in these two sales.
My man.
So no problem with it. That was my hot eight this week. No odd 5 to 10 in this. Each week, y'all know my sales goal during the holiday season is $1,500. $1,500, not gross selling. Gross is before you take out any fees, cost of goods, anything like that. That's the number that you'll hear most of the time when these people are out here faking a funk on the nasty dunk, throwing y'all these ridiculous numbers. Oh my God, this clickbait. I sold $4,500 this week. No, you didn't.
Nope.
Stop your lying. You're talking about gross sales. Take out the fees and tell me how much you made. So my net sales goal is $1,500 each week. Net sales. After you take out all your fees, cost of goods. How do I figure out my net sales? It's really simple. eBay charges on average about 10% fee per item sold. On average, when you'll manage payments. I advertise all of my items at 4%. So I take the item that I sell without the shipping fee. I multiply that by 14%. That gives me how much eBay has charged me. And then I take out the cost of goods from that average. And that gives me how much I actually made from selling this item.
What?
It's that simple. Y'all stop being lying out there on the gram. Put your real numbers out there. I'm going to put a challenge out there. I hate challenges, but I'm going to put a challenge. Show me your real numbers. How about that? Anyhow, did I hit my $1,500 this week? Let's go in and see. Now, y'all saw I had some big sales this week. I had the highest gross selling day I've ever had. Over $1,100 in one day. I could have posted that as clickbait. $1,100 sold in one day. I would have got hella hits. Not realizing, guess what? I didn't make that much from that because I had more on the cost of goods. I paid more for those items. Let's go to my Seagram 7 sales board and see what I ended up with this week. So $1,500 is my goal. 1,500 buckaroos. Did I hit my goal this week? Let's go and see. Hey. There we have it. $1,423. I barely missed my goal. I'm okay. Look, I'm happy with those numbers. I'm not gonna complain. I sold 82 items last week. An average of $17.35. Now you're asking, well, what happened to that big day? As I told you, depends on how much you spend. That big day was on Thursday, right? $1,047 is what I sold on that day. I made $365 net sales. Still good. That's because the cost of goods were high. That was the two laptops, a Lululemon pair of pants. High cost of goods on there. So keep it real. That's what I made from it. You see, each day was steady. 194, 349. Tuesday fell off. I normally always have one of those days a week. $74. And so on and so forth. My board, if you're new to my channel, it's real simple. My board tells me how many active items I have, my newly posted items, my gross sales, my net sales, my items sold, and then I put my totals here on the bottom. All right, y'all see the totals. This week I did post more though. I posted 90 items this week. I'm so happy about that. Because I posted more than I sold. Yep. That's what I want each week. That's my goal each week. It's kind of hard to do in the holiday season, but that's what I want. Those are my numbers, man. For those of y'all out there posting and not seeing the instant gratification, the instant number, calm down. We still got a couple of weeks left before Christmas. There are a lot of last-minute shoppers. A lot of last-minute shoppers. They're going to come hit your store hard. Hard. Now, since everything's shut down across the country, please be ready. Refresh your listings. Run a sale. 10% sale. Is your product set up like that? If you can't run a 10% sale and still make profit, you're picking up the wrong stuff. You're picking up the wrong stuff. If your profit margins are that tight to where you can't run a 10% sale in your store, you're picking up the wrong items. Just word to the wise on that. Hope y'all looked at my video last week. Me and Calvin doing our thing. It was a fun video. This Saturday, I have a video. I got this from Matt. And he did a little interview with Eric, Flipping Eric. So I am going to start a series on that. Probably dropping a video every Saturday. Called Random Skype Videos.
Nope.
Or something. I gotta come up with Random Skype Interviews with Hustlers. I don't know. I'm gonna come up sometime. And that's gonna be a series I'm gonna do. It takes a lot of time. Matt will tell you from Front Range Flips. It takes a lot of time to cut those videos, man. Like, it took me 2 hours, 2.5 hours to really get everything together on the dance-off video. So it takes a while, but hopefully y'all enjoy that. I look forward to watching all your videos this week. Go out there and hustle, y'all. Stay positive. Stop comparing yourself to others, and I'll talk to you soon. Have a great day.